life, love, relationships.
Wait, we're going to give away all our secrets?
Welcome to The Man Perspective.
With K-Man.
And The Dawn.
Today on The Man Perspective, we're talking about how to set boundaries in your relationship.
I think the first thing you have to do is when you communicate with your significant other or spouse, you have to let them know what it is you like, what it is you don't like.
Man.
You got to start there. That's the first boundary. This is what I like. This is what I don't like. Now, either you can deal with it or you can't deal with it. That first boundary's been set.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I agree 100%. Just like a lot of things, or with the majority of things with a relationship, communication is going to be one of those key factors, right? You have to communicate your boundaries. And like you said, this is what I like. This is what I don't like. Boundary number one. But in order to do that, you got to communicate. And it's got to start somewhere. Whether it is that boundary of this is what I like, this is what I don't like, there's no wiggle room there, or it's something else, you have to do it. Communicate it. Stand by it.
Do you feel like life is boring? Perhaps your love life is at a loss? Maybe even your relationships are just a little bit sour? Well, we got the advice for you. Tune in to The Man Perspective, weekly, for all the hot topics, and we can get your life, love, and relationships back into the swing of things on The Man Perspective with K-Man
and The Don. Is there anything that you put forth first besides that? Like, especially with the no boundaries, how comfortable are you setting the no boundaries in the relationship?
Oh, I have non-negotiables. They're not even boundaries. It's just simply shit I'm not dealing with.
Wow.
I have no problem coming out and saying it right off the bat. Like, I'm not dealing with drama of any kind. Like, if they're, you know, all right, whatever, we have an argument, that's between us. Okay, that's one thing. But I'm not dealing with, like, just bullshit drama. Like, I'm not dealing with your ex-boyfriends trying to start fights. I'm not dealing with, like, your past coming back to haunt us in this new relationship. I'm not dealing with frivolous drama crap. I'm not going
to
do it.
But what if you get dragged into it, though, and you have to deal with it? Now,
Then we'll deal with it, and we're going to deal with it very swift, and I'm going to make sure I deal with it to the point where it's not going to happen again. Because one of the biggest deal breakers for me is drama. Like, if I want drama, I go to work. I'm not trying to have it when I come home. Like, when I come home, I want to be able to spend time with my partner, see how her day was. Maybe she asked me about my day, and we enjoy our time together, us, right? And whatever it is we're doing that day or that night, and just, I want to be able to enjoy that time, right? Not be aggravated because now there's some kind of bullshit drama going on that's like, okay, so it's like being at work all over again. So that's my number one non-negotiable. And I'm pretty easy to deal with. That's probably my only non-negotiable besides, like, you know, an obvious one of like, I'm not dealing with like cheating. But I think everybody has that same boundary or non-negotiable. But that's really my only hard-pressed non-negotiable is I'm not dealing with drama.
It's official. The Man Perspective is now on Apple Music, Android Podcasts, Spotify, Anchor, and a bunch of other platforms. We are now international and coming to you weekly. Even check us out on our YouTube channel. You don't want to miss this. Things are about to get real, real crazy on The Man Perspective with K-Man
and The Don. What about your must-have boundaries? Do you have a must-have boundary that you set in your relationship? Like, you must do this.
Not really. I mean, if I had to pick one, I'm not dealing with immaturity. There's a time and a place for it. But if it's, like I said on a previous episode, if it's your normal operating mode to be 100% of the time immature, I can't deal with that. Like, we're adults. You got to be an adult. There is a time and a place to act like a 5-year-old. But it's not all the time.
Well, how do you set that, though? How do you set that boundary for her to behave the way you want her to behave? Like, we all joke around, we all have fun, but how do you set that?
It's not really even a boundary that I set, right? I will never jump into a relationship. I always date some people for a little while, and I try to get a good sense of their personality and who they are. And during that whole time, I'm assessing it. And if I see that you're just flat out an immature individual, I just kind of cut it off, really. Like, I don't end up getting into a relationship. So it's not even really a boundary. It's just a personal thing that I refuse to deal with. So I guess it's a personal boundary. It's not necessarily a relationship boundary. It's just a personal one. So that's
but how do you get her to agree that that's the boundary you're setting in that relationship?
Oh, I don't. It's not even something that's agreed upon. It's just something that I deal with myself while I'm seeing that person and in the, that initial phase of like dating. So I don't even bring it up. It's just something that I observe.
It puts it as though you control that relationship by you already have a boundaries within yourself, which is cool.
Kind of.
But how do you let her know that you got these boundaries within your boundaries within yourself?
Well, for the no drama one, I mean, I just bring it up like early on too, when I'm like seeing the person or dating them, like I'm just like, look, I am not about drama. I don't want it. And I'm not going to deal with it. And if it's going to be all drama, let's just go our separate ways now. For the other one, for the personal boundary, I don't communicate it. I don't say a word. I just observe. And if I notice that that person is just completely immature, I'm just like, look, this isn't for me. It was nice meeting you. Adios.
But don't you want to let her know, like, what you're thinking, that that's not what you want? I mean, because you got to communicate that to her some way, right?
So Yes and no.
Because if you keep her in the dark, she's never going to know that that's one of your boundaries that's set in stone, that, you know, no matter what, you don't want her to be childish or what have you. So True. If she doesn't know that, how is she going to know to not do that in front of you? Like, not.
Well, see, that's the thing. If I notice that that person is just immature all the time, we never get into a relationship. I cut it off before we're in a relationship, more so in the seeing dating phase. And it's not even something I talk about. Like, when it comes to people, some people, a lot of people, don't change. They're very set in their ways, and people don't change unless they want to change. So, and especially something like immaturity, that's very hard to change in a person because it's the opposite of being mature. Like, if you can't act like an adult and this is your normal operating mode, you're probably just an immature person. And then I'm just like, yeah, I don't think this is working out. This is not really for me. It was nice meeting you. Good luck in your next venture.
Well, you heard it first, ladies. On the man perspective, we set the boundaries in the relationship, and you have to hear from it. So, hey, get at us at themanperspective@gmail.com and let us know what you think with men setting boundaries in a relationship, or you setting boundaries in a relationship. You know, how does that come across? You hear it right here on The Man Perspective. Now you heard our perspective. It's time to hear yours. Get at us at themanperspective@gmail.com.
Or use the hashtag TheManPerspective.